Shayna Baszler responds to her loss to Doudrop on Monday Night Raw. Top AEW star congratulates Xavier Woods for making it to the final of the King of the Ring. And the Young Bucks take a jab at SmackDown after AEW Rampage's ratings triumph. What's up, everyone? I'm Jose G, and there's a lot to talk about in today's Sports Keto Wrestling WWE News Roundup. Never miss brand new content by liking, sharing, and subscribing to our YouTube channel. Shayna Baszler responds to her loss to Doudrop on Monday Night Raw. Shayna Baszler was considered for weeks to be a heavy favorite to win the Queen's Crown Tournament, but this week on Raw, her march to Crown Jewel came to a crushing end. This week on Raw, Baszler lost to Doudrop in the semifinals of the tournament, meaning the finals will now see Zelina Vega take on Doudrop in Saudi Arabia. Shortly after a disappointing loss on Raw, Shayna Baszler took to Twitter to express her thoughts on her loss and her current state of mind, saying, quote, "I've been to Saudi more than once and don't need a tournament to tell me what I am," end quote. Rumors online were suggesting that apart from WWE's decision to not book Shayna Baszler in the finals of the tournament was due to Baszler's sexuality, stating that the Saudi Arabian government would not allow her to compete at Crown Jewel. However, there does not seem to be any credible evidence supporting that claim. While Shayna Baszler maintains her confidence this loss to Doudrop has fans concerned, many WWE fans also took to Twitter expressing their concerns that Shayna Baszler's fairly new push might be over. Fans also noted that Shayna Baszler and Doudrop's match was extremely short following the trend of every single match in the Queen's Crown Tournament. None of the six matches in the tournament so far have gone past the 3-minute mark. Overall, WWE fans have been highly disappointed with WWE's booking of the Queen's Crown Tournament. Shayna Baszler's loss on Monday Night Raw did not make fans feel any better. Later this week, Shayna Baszler will officially make her move to Friday Night SmackDown after being drafted to the Blue Brand during the WWE Draft. While she is still technically a member of the Raw roster, Baszler made an appearance on the supersized edition of SmackDown this past Friday. Baszler arrived on SmackDown just before the scheduled match between WWE official Sonya Deville and Naomi. Deville would quickly announce that Baszler would be joining the match as her partner. She helped her dismantle Naomi, a feud that will clearly continue after Crown Jewel. Alexa Bliss teases a gimmick change on Twitter. Alexa Bliss has just made a big tease on Twitter in regards to her character. Bliss hasn't wrestled on WWE TV ever since her Raw Women's title loss to Charlotte Flair at Extreme Rules. She's reportedly on hiatus and she is set to undergo sinus surgery. There's no telling how long Bliss's break will last though. Her fans are eagerly waiting to see her back on WWE TV. Amidst all the speculation regarding her possible return date, Bliss posted a big tease on her Twitter handle. Alexa Bliss posted a GIF that shows her undergoing an interesting transformation. The GIF hints that Bliss could possibly ditch the dark persona and bring back her old character. Alexa Bliss was attacked by The Fiend on SmackDown last year, thus began her descent into the dark side. Bliss soon joined Bray Wyatt and embraced her other disturbing side. The duo made their way to Monday Night Raw during the 2020 WWE Draft and began terrorizing the Red Brand superstars. Bliss and Wyatt kicked off a heated feud with WWE veteran Randy Orton, which lasted for months on end. Bliss interfered in Wyatt's WrestleMania 37 match against the Viper, thus resulting in a win for Orton. Wyatt was later released by WWE while Bliss kept working as a sinister heel. Her character has received quite a mixed reaction, but most have lauded Bliss for nailing it quite well. Top AEW star congratulates Xavier Woods for making it to the King of the Ring final. Top AEW star and former NXT champion Adam Cole took to Twitter to congratulate Xavier Woods for making it to the King of the Ring final. Cole and Woods are close friends in real life and their friendship is well documented as they formed The Party alongside Cesaro and Tyler Breeze. In a reply to a tweet from Cesaro, Adam Cole expressed his thoughts on Xavier Woods making it to the finals of the King of the Ring tournament. Going by his reaction, Cole certainly loved the moment. Earlier this week, Xavier Woods defeated Jinder Mahal in the semifinals of the King of the Ring to edge closer to his dream of winning the prestigious tournament. Woods now faces a daunting challenge in the finals where he goes up against the Prince Finn Balor at Crown Jewel in Saudi Arabia. While Cole may no longer be part of Vince McMahon's promotion, he certainly doesn't shy away from congratulating or appreciating his friends from time to time. Last month, Adam Cole expressed his thoughts on Xavier Woods' superkick from the main event. With all his friends rooting for him and the audience firmly behind him, this could be the start of something special for Xavier Woods. Kevin Owens seemingly set for character change on Monday Night Raw return. As part of the 2021 WWE draft, Kevin Owens was drafted back over to Monday Night Raw, where it appears that he could be about to undergo a character reset. WWE played a teaser video promoting Owens' return to the brand next week, where it was clear that the company was looking to forget his recent months spent languishing in the mid-card on SmackDown. Over the past few months, Kevin Owens has been underutilized on SmackDown and was stuck in a continuous loop where he would be used as a part of a throwaway segment or feuds. It's clear that Owens needs a refresh at this point in his career, and his recent move over to Monday Night Raw could help him out with that. On May 18, 2015, Owens made a surprise debut on the main roster where he could dominate the brand even though he was the NXT champion. At the time, Owens was seen as the prize fighter and only cared about adding gold to his collection. If the recent videos that the company is using to build up Owens' return to the brand is anything to go by, then WWE could be teasing the return of this gimmick. The former Universal Champion was once seen as one of the biggest stars in the company. This even saw Triple H turn on Seth Rollins to put him over. It's obvious that his potential has been wasted following his move over to SmackDown, and now Owens needs something to allow him to pick up where he left off. This move over to Raw could be a way for WWE to reset Owens' timeline and allow him to push towards championship glory in the company. The Young Bucks take a jab at SmackDown after AEW's Rampage's ratings triumph. The Young Bucks recently took a cheeky dig at SmackDown after AEW Rampage drew more viewers in the key demo than the Blue Brand show last Friday night. Rampage and SmackDown went head-to-head for 30 minutes from 10 to 10:30. While the latter expectedly handed a loss to the former in overall ratings, Rampage won in the 18 to 49 age group. The show drew 328,000 viewers compared to SmackDown's 285,000 in the 30-minute overlap. The Young Bucks are no strangers to taking shots and digs at the who's who's of the wrestling industry by regularly updating their Twitter bios. From wrestling veterans to their rivals to even WWE, nobody is spared from the former AEW Tag Team Champions' witty jabs. In their latest bio, the Young Bucks referenced the catchphrase, "One more for the good guys," used by Kevin Nash and Scott Hall, the Outsiders in WCW. The duo altered it by writing "another one for the good guys," seemingly referring to AEW's Rampage as the good guys over WWE SmackDown a few days back. The new SmackDown faction hit row, Top Dollar, seemingly took a shot at the Young Bucks and their fondness for sneakers. In retaliation, Matt and Nick Jackson responded by updating their Twitter bio. The duo wrote that they spent more sneakers in September than the entire NXT roster did. Later, the Young Bucks' fellow AEW colleague Max Caster also took shots at Top Dollar, saying he raps better than the SmackDown superstar. Thanks for watching today's Sports Keto Wrestling WWE News Roundup. For exclusive content you never want to miss, you gotta subscribe to our YouTube channel and smash that notification bell so you never miss whenever we drop brand new content. Follow us on all social media and download the Sports Keto app for the most up-to-date stories in the world of wrestling.